For today's cool engineering project, we will make a Lego car with a light.
What's this?
It's a pleasant foliage.
A surprise for the end of the show.
First, we need to make the tall.
Now we need to wire up a light. How shall we do that?
We can use a wire to connect a battery to a little LED Christmas light.
Great, so why does connecting the battery to the light bulb make it light up? Electricity is what you get when electrons move, and electrons can only move if there's a complete path or circuit for them to flow through. When we connect this circuit and electricity reaches the bulb, it lights up. If we just connect the circuit we've drawn, we'll burn out the LED. Shall we see what happens? I'm going to connect this to the battery. So we have leads connected, and then I need to touch them very carefully. Here, and we'll see. So that burned out this LED bulb, which won't light up anymore. Now, do you know why that happened?
Because it made a little short circuit.
And what does that mean?
It got too hot.
I think so. It put too much electricity through the LED. Sometimes it can be helpful to think about electricity as behaving like water. Imagine that you have two buckets, each filled with water and having a hole in its bottom connected to a hose. On the free end of each hose is a balloon. One bucket is on the bottom step of a ladder and the other is on the top step. The water in the hose connected to the bucket on the top step will be under more pressure, so it will result in a larger water balloon. If we take the balloons off, water will flow out of the high pressure hose faster than the low pressure hose. Just like the water in the hose can be at different pressures, electricity can be at different voltages. And just like with water, the electric flow, or current, of its circuit is higher when the voltage is higher. You're probably wondering how this relates to that light bulb we just burned out. Well, the LED bulb is built for a certain amount of current. Too much current will break the light. So, what should we do to reduce the current?
We can add a resistor which will lower the current in the circuit. A resistor in a circuit works the same way as a hand squeezing a hose slows down the flow of water through the hose.
Let's try it with the light bulb.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
Let's put this thing together.
Does it work?
Now? Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Now you might not have a resistor handy. If you don't have a resistor, what else could you use?
Potato.
Potato? Oh. Potato. Let's see. Will a potato work?
Maybe.
Well, if you don't have a potato, other objects around the house could work as well. You could try damp potting soil. You could try other fruits or vegetables. You can try a tube of toothpaste. Let's see what this potato does. Ready? Let's see. Does it work?
Yes.
Yes. Well, that's cool, but a regular resistor is easier to attach.
Let's put the light on the towel. Do you want to see what's in this? Do you want to see what's in the surprise?
Yes, I want to see what's in the surprise. Yes. What is it?
Here.
A bow tie?
Here.
This is an awesome light-up bow tie. Did you guys make this?
Yes.
Yes.
Check out our show next month when we'll be taking apart a broken drone to build a propeller-powered car. Please leave us a comment to let us know what you think and to send us your ideas for wacky hacks. If you enjoy our show, please subscribe and check out our website at geekpackhack.com.